So the motivation of the Net Desktop is to have a very simple prototyping of neuron networks. And here you can easily construct network with some graphical elements. And you can add nodes or can connect nodes using mouse interaction. You're also able to select node models or set parameters of neurons or inputs. And then it starts to run the simulation. After the simulation, show the visualization of the activity using spike data in raster plot or line traces for analog signals. If neuron contained positions, for instance, spatial involve network model, so it shows the animation. So the good point of this is there's no programming skills required. As you want to have, give your student an opportunity to learn about the neuroscientific concept without having a problem with programming. So the next slide I showed is under the hood, I showed the architecture of the Nest Desktop. You have two systems. So the user interface, there's a web interface, is the front end, and it sends the request to the back end. And in the back end, there's a Docker, and there's, for instance, a Nest simulator installed. And then this performs the simulation, goes back to the front end. So in the front end, you're able to construct the network. It generates script for the Nest simulator and then goes back to the front end and visualize it. So I want to show where you can use Nest Desktop, that you can have an access on Nest Desktop on eprint.eu. There's some link and it directs you to this link nestdesktop.apps.hppeu. But HPP account is required, but it's for free. You can ask for account and you will get one. And then you can exit. So, but you are able to deploy or install Nest Desktop on your own computer. So when you have a Docker on your computer, then you can just Docker pull /nest-desktop and it will pull on your local machine. And then you can start it with Docker run Nest Desktop. There's a documentation in Nest Desktop readthedocs.io. And there's also public in the PIP repository. And Nest Desktop is open source, so everyone can see the code. You are welcome to contribute to this Nest Desktop. This is the first page when you see. Basically, you can use eBrains So go to the Nest and view prototype online so you get access. And there's the interface. But I want to show my local installation because it's the latest development that provides more features, but still unstable. So here, there's the editor for network. You can add nodes, for instance here. There's a neuron node, and it contains some parameters showing on the right side. You're able to modify parameters. And you're able to increase the population size of the neuron. So, and you can also add stimulator and connect to this neuron. And you can also select another input model. So another stimulator using parser generator. increase the mean fun rate, and of course you want to have to record this neuron. And this recorder is the voltmeter. This records voltage of the neuron. So if you are ready, you start the simulation. Of course, there's some mess up. So I will reset all parameters of the neuron. So you see, there's traces of the voltage. So now I want to decrease the fun rate to 10 spike input, and you see there's small responses for 10 spikes. Okay, let's start to have a neural network using an excitatory population and inhibitory population. So it's now we want to create a new network. I created two populations, one excitatory, it's connected itself, and two inhibitory. And goes down, you can also set the amount of connections, all to all means that all neurons from this population connect to all neurons of the target population. But I want to have fixed in degree. Okay, first I set the amount of the neurons in excitatory to 800 and inhibitory to 200 neurons. So in total we have 1000 neurons. Now the fixed in degree is 10% of 800 is 80. And two inhibitory also 80. So connect within inhibitory and back to excitatory. This is 10% is 20, and it's also 20, because this is an inhibitory population, which means that this synaptic weight has to be set negative. It's minus one. Okay. So now we have two neuron populations. Now we want to have spike input. So you can also move graphical elements. This will be a parser generator and this notch. There's only one parser generator node. You can also decide to have 10 elements of the parser generator and reduce the frame rate. But this gets slower. So I decide to have only one parser generator and increase the mean frame rate. Now we want to record neurons. So switch to recorder, and it should record spike detector. Okay, now I'm ready for that, and then we can start the simulation. Okay. Sometimes I told you this is not stable, but I can save this network configuration and reload this. I can reload the entire page. Okay, start the simulation. Now you can see the spike trains. Okay. Yeah, maybe confusing of so much parameters of the neuron. You can set level of view. It's reduced to very few abstraction of parameters. So I will add one more stimulator and connect to inhibitory population. And this will be also a pulsar generator. And the firm rate will be 1000. And you can start at 300 milliseconds and stop at 700 milliseconds. And you can start the simulation. You see here, there's an increase of inhibitory population activity, but it doesn't affect on activity of excitatory population. So I will have a negative input and see what happens. Okay. I forget to consider important rule of the Brunner network. It contains the synaptic factor of inhibitory. So I will use the excitatory to 5 picoampere, and inhibitory is 4 times stronger than excitatory. Now you see there's an oscillation at this point when the external input starts. Okay, there's an opportunity to learn the different dynamics of the networks or of neurons just by using in the web browser. So I'm able to show some other examples. And in this example, I can also show the animation of spiking. I'm able to generate positions. So if I increase input, and of course it shows more activity. If I decreased, and it changes. Okay, go back to three-dimensional space. I can also increase to 1,000 neurons. This takes a few seconds. And I increase the resolution of the simulator. And show the activity of 1,000 neurons. So start the animation. I'm able to increase the size of the dots. Okay, interaction between the neurons, and you have a just a step input to one neuron. And you can increase the amplitude. It will simulate after change. And you see the scale is increasing. And now this reaches the threshold and starts to spike. Maybe for students better to compare two different neurons. I can also delete connections and add another stimulator. So this stimulator will have 300 75. Oh, this is a sharing path. I showed with the other recorder. So now you can see one neuron spikes the other neuron node. So this orange neuron spikes because the current input is 376. This higher than real base current, and 375 is the real base current. That's just below the threshold. The threshold is minus 55 millivolt. Now I'm able to decrease it and switch to Gaussian white noise. But I increase the standard deviation. Okay, maybe I make a stronger decrease of. You see, there's a startup fluctuation and increase the standard deviation. Because of the input variance, there is not a regular spiking of the neuron. So I can also increase the number of neurons. Then you can see that each neuron has a different responses because of the different fluctuations. Okay, importantly, students are able to save it. And this network configuration will be saved, and the student is able to download all protocols into file storage, and I'm able to delete all, and you can upload protocols, and it will be uploaded. Okay. One more feature is that here it shows a script for Nest Simulator, and if you created a neuron and you see this code for neuron is generated, you can reduce the visibility of parameters. I want to only show the spike threshold, and it's also only show the spike threshold instead of all parameters. So next, so I'm able to set, okay. And then here it's connect between two nodes. And there's the recorder and the simulator. And you see that it's the whole script is generated. And you can also copy the script and paste into Python interface. For instance, Jupyter Notebook or another Python interface. But it will produce the same results. Okay. Besides two, a simulation or network, it's also have information or description of the different models. For instance, when students want to know about specific neural model, it gives some description of the parameters and information, and also some references. Or if what is the difference between conductance-based and current-based neural model, So it will show. Of course, only these models are integrated in NetDeskop, but NetDeskop provides much more models. There's lots of models which is implemented in Nest Simulator. Also, for Synapse, you have a different Synapse models. I only use the static synapses. So in the future, I want to have more management with a neural model or Synapse model that people can add to the NetDeskop.